Okay, next question is from Haley Cockcroft, and she is a new member. Welcome to the Gardenstead community, Haley. This is a good question. It's a timely question too. She says, why is my alocasia turning yellow? Does he need more light? I had him under a grow light, but he got sunburned, so I don't turn it on very much now.
This is a really interesting question because there are several things that are maybe to me a bit confusing, and that is grow lights, unless you're dealing with an extremely powerful grow light, will not really burn anything. In fact, they're just so much weaker than the sun that, I mean, until you measure light, you would just not even believe. So that's kind of one thing that's kind of interesting to me. If she's talking about burned as in maybe like brown edges or something, typically what happens is, do we have any brown edges here? Maybe not on these ones because these are not quite that old yet. But anyway, if you have like spider plants, perfect example, the edges of the leaf turn brown or crispy like that. I mean, although to us it looks like what a sun might do to burn and something and dry it up, but it's actually the fact that water minerals are being filtered by your leaves all the time. And eventually cells and leaves give out and they die, and that's typically what happens to the edges of a lot of tropical foliage plants.
Right, so I wouldn't worry about it being burned under your grow light.
Yes.
So you can take that out of your vocabulary.
Right. Now, the other thing, especially with alocasia, is alocasia leaves do not last forever. They last, I don't know, if you're lucky, 4 to 5 months.
This is something I learned this year. I wasn't partial to the alocasia poly before. Mm-hmm. I wasn't super attracted to it. I love it now. Mm-hmm. But this is a bulb.
It's a bulb, yes.
So it dies.
Yeah.
It dies back.
What happens is, you know, the bulb is in the ground, and so it shoots out new leaves. Those new leaves stay around collecting light, storing that energy that it's the food that is making photosynthesis, right? Storing that energy into the bulb until finally it gives out, so the leaves all turn yellow, all die back. So literally you'll be sitting there with the pot of nothing, right? But what you do is you take the bulb out, shake off some old soil, put it into a fresh pot of soil, and then again put it back where it's going to get that big wide view of the sky, or in the case of your grow light, turn it on 12 hours day on, 12 hours on, 12 hours off. Then maybe new leaves will grow, and the new leaves will grow back, but probably not as numerous as when you first bought the plant.
So we will put up a picture of what our alocasia poly bulb looks like now, because all of our leaves fell off. And so my question for you, Daryl, to help Haley with this is, once you have it with all the leaves are gone, so Haley, don't be afraid to snip off these leaves once they start dying back. Don't worry about that. Clean the plant up, snip those leaves off an inch or so above the soil line. Once all of the foliage has died back, you have the bulb, let's say you transferred it to new soil or not right away, how often do you water?
So this is a bit tricky because now you're dealing with a plant that is essentially resting, right? So it's not going to be sucking in the water all that much. At the same time, you can't leave it dry, bone dry, otherwise the plant itself will start to desiccate, right? So, I mean, I would say water the plant nice and evenly, let the excess water drain away. Make sure that it's not like sitting in a stale corner somewhere where that like airflow is just going to be kind of stagnant, right?
Yeah.
You want to now leverage some evaporation to help it dry out a little bit more. And I would say check it every few days. And the moment, let's say the top inch or two of soil is like totally dry, then I would take a chopstick and gently loosen it a bit. And then water it again.
Okay, because I'm not watering the one we have in our workspace very often.
So maybe, you see, here's the thing. Like, sometimes when you see just a pot of soil, it's kind of discouraging, and you're almost like not even wanting to water it, right?
Yeah.
And then it ends up dying.
Right. I wonder how ours is doing, but that's
the thing. With oxalis, on the other hand, oxalis, they do the same thing. All of their leaves just die off. You replant it and it'll start growing again. But the good thing about oxalis is it starts growing much quicker mm-hmm. like in terms of re-blooming, right? It comes back much faster than oxalis.
How fast-ish, if you had to do an approximation to help Haley out? Are we talking 2 weeks or 2 months?
I would say you're looking at 2 months.
Okay, yep. So good luck and keep us updated.
Yeah.